Pikaniti, it is the responsibility of the church to speak to you, not to preach to you, but rather empower you through the wedding service to understand the intricacies of a wedded married life. So all best wishes, firstly, in the name of the vicar and the deacon and the church members, family and friends, to you both for getting married today after the end of the service. May God Almighty bless you and fill you with love and patience to start your wedded life with happiness. And may the glorious Trinity offer you numerous ways of opportunity and togetherness, that you will always be protected and guided under the wings of God's assuring care. There will be some tension for you today. You think that you have to be the best dressed and most beautiful and handsome on this day. There will be, in this sense, a lot of scrutiny, but I don't think you need to be concerned about that at all. Marriage is a relationship and not a wedding. This is our first point for you today. The church believes that even as you come to the institution or the church to get married, in witness of all who are here, the reverend priests and your family members and friends, that they are in being only because of their relationship with each other. Today, you are here not to be part of a wedding, but to be part of a relationship. A wedding can break at any time, but a relationship will last forever. They usually say that it takes only one day, one week, sometimes only one month to get into a relationship, but it takes a lifetime to forget a relationship. So today we hope that you are here to be in relationship and cling on to his wife. Khalil Gibran has a very nice quotation on the relationship between parents and children. He says, and I quote, "Your children are not your children. They are the sons and daughters of lives longing for itself. They come through you, but not from you. And though they are with you, yet they belong not to you." In a marriage, this is what is primarily happening. You have been brought up by your family. They have loved you. They wish the best for you. So always know that you have to be good to each other. They always say that when you study, you have to be good to your classmates. Because Nitin's classmates have come, I think. The reason for that is you never know what your classmate is going to be tomorrow. He may or she may be the principal of an institution, maybe a big officer, maybe a policeman or woman, maybe a chief minister, may even go on to be the prime minister of this country. We don't know. There is no limit to dreams. And therefore, being in relationship with someone is so important, because that relationship then gives you a binding factor with another person. There are many of my schoolmates who are now in touch with me. Specifically, one of them, and I will tell you why. Once, I think in our 9th or 10th standard, he, after writing an exam, came to me, cried and said, "I think I'm going to fail the exam." Usually friends can be very happy when they hear that, because it means one has gone down and we have gone up. But in this case, I did not answer anything first. Some of the other friends would have usually said, "Don't worry, it is not to say that we are better than someone, but it is to come down to the level of someone because we care for them." We hope that today this is what is going to start. And we have several characters in the Bible, Priscilla and Aquila, Joseph and Mary, who are models for us in relationship. Second, marriage is ministering to one another and as one another. It means that from today, you are going to be crowned. So in the second part of the service, it is called Blessing of the Crowns. Today we don't use crowns, but we are using two chains with a cross on the tip. Why we are using that is because the concept is that from today onwards you are crown. You are king and queen. So from today onwards you are King Nitin and Queen Bika. If people knew this earlier, they would have come much before and got married in the Jacobite church. Unfortunately, they haven't been able to get the message through. So this is the case that you have to realize. But you are not a king and queen without any responsibility or kingdom. From today onwards, the house becomes your kingdom. And the house becomes your church. We are always very quick to criticize the church, never realizing that we are the church. So from today, Nitin and Bika, you should open your house to others. You should realize that your house is not brick and cement, but your house is a house of hospitality, love and care. You must understand that other people would like to come to you and be part of you. And this is what the church is saying, that we are wearing a church, a crown of thorns. But it is a crown of thorns only to those who think that it is a crown of thorns. For others, it's a crown. And it's a crown that we accept. So marriage, for some, is suffering. We recently talked about a convention speaker who was very popular among the youth of the CSI church in Bangalore. So a person once told me last week that he sent his son to him and say, why don't you take care of him for a week and let him know what's happening in the youth programs. So this son comes and he talks of his father, who is basically the dream person of the youth. He is the most attractive person in the youth. He is the person who everyone looks up to. And the son of this father, priest, comes to this youth member and says, I hate my father. Death, you are. May God bless you next week.